This is ridiculous.
Everyone has to say the password, stranger. Even you.
An intruder would be dead by now.
Rules, stranger. You think I enjoy sitting in this little box all day?
Your enjoyment does not concern me.
The password, stranger.
By this point, I could have killed you and flipped the switch to open the door myself.
You wouldn't do that, would you?
The world is a dark place.
Who will protect the world from darkness?
We will, after we play our stupid games.
Have a nice day.
What's left of it?
Ah, stranger. I have a somewhat personal request.
Do you know anything about this request?
Nothing. He didn't say anything about it to us. But he does seem unusually nervous today.
Don't ask me. I've only been here a couple of years, and I'm still trying to figure out this organization. Greetings, soldier.
General Biggs.
I see you two have a mission to discuss, so I will take my leave now. It was good to see you again, Hapscom. Stranger.
Do you have time after this briefing, perhaps?
No, unfortunately, I have a meeting at 1300 hours in Pennsylvania.
Just as well, I have an immense amount of paperwork to attend to.
I know what you mean.
Thanks for stopping by, General. It is always a pleasure to speak with you.
Goodbye, Colonel. Good luck on your mission, soldier.
Do you remember Hamilton Killian?
He was an operative, just before I came to Spook House.
That's right. He served Spook House from 1909 to 1922. He's retired now, living in France. He contacted me recently requesting help. He says that a graveyard near his estate outside of Paris has been disturbed by supernatural activity.
Killian was supposed to be the best in his day. What could possibly be a problem for him?
He didn't offer much detail in his letter, but apparently the phenomena occurring there are more than even he can handle. He's requested that I send Spook House's best monster hunter.
Me.
Who else?
Not now, stranger. I'm busy.
It is good to see you. A rare occasion, true, but good. For what purpose are you here, stranger?
I'm going on a mission to assist Hamilton Killian.
Killian? I haven't heard that name in some time. An unfortunate story behind that man. A dark spot grew in his essence, and it nearly consumed him. Strange that he should have to seek assistance. He was quite thorough in his day. My advice to you is be extra cautious, stranger. This must be a very dangerous operation. Now we need silence as I help Haystack mentally prepare for his mission. It is time for you to meditate, my son.
What's the objective?
Have you heard of Hamilton Killian?
Of course. Who here hasn't?
I don't know much about him.
He was Spookhouse's best monster hunter before the stranger and I got here. He took an early retirement or something. Apparently he had a nervous breakdown.
His wife was killed by a vampire. He turned into a veritable killing machine afterwards. Pushed him over the top when Spookhouse allowed Moloch to join.
Moloch? I've seen him on the bulletin board. Haystack talks about him sometimes. Says he was the biggest badass he'd ever seen. Misses sparring with him. He told me that being around Moloch made you scared, like he was emitting some type of evil energy. That's the one thing Haystack wanted to overcome most.
He met Spookhouse agents during the Nepalese Horicide. He joined our ranks to carry out his vengeance on those who had cast him out. He proved a valuable asset to the team. He disappeared on a mission to Spain about 7 years ago. Killian had a really intense hatred for all monsters. Not unlike the stranger here. When Spookhouse allowed a full-blooded demon to join its ranks, he could not accept that. Honestly, I'm glad he retired before I joined. The stranger's dislike of monsters is bad enough, but from what I've heard, Killian's hatred was almost evil.
Welcome to my home. I'm glad I can still rely upon my old friends at Spookhouse. My name is Hamilton Killian. I hear I'm to call you Stranger.
Yes. Colonel Hapscombe speaks highly of you.
Well, it's nice to know that I'm remembered. The Colonel is a good man.
So what's the situation?
A couple of months ago, one of my groundskeepers disappeared without a trace. While searching the grounds, I found that some of the corpses in the nearby graveyard had risen, and smaller, imp-like demons were running rampant. I took those creatures down, but a couple of nights later, they returned, and their numbers had increased. I returned periodically to keep them in check. To my dismay, they began regenerating faster and faster. To be honest, going out night after night to deal with them was more of a nuisance than anything else. But now there are so many monsters that I fear for my property and my safety. As I said, I can take them down, but they just keep coming back. You might say that I'm at my wit's end. I hate to have this incident sully my image, but I gave up my grandiose monster hunting days long ago. The Colonel assures me that you are just the man to take care of my little problem.
It won't be a problem for long.
Splendid old chap. I trust you will not be needing my assistance. I will remain here. Just follow this path and it will take you to the graveyard. Happy hunting.
This must be Killian's groundskeeper. Damn. No keys. Those damn imps must have done something with them. I've gotta find them. looks like something is missing from this pillar. Looks like something is missing from this pillar. A witch's staff. This is the source of the problem. Another inscription. Fire and water and air of dark worth. In a room far beneath the earth, find the marble tomb of birth. To an altar surrounded by graves, the destination of the three is paved. For sea air consumed by hellish fire, and the liquid that will douse the funeral pyre, behold, leaving water with air is the only desire. If one destroyed, of those that remain, replace to origin and resurrect again. That's wrong. The water is dousing the fire. magic. Killian knows black magic. His little monster problem reeks of foul play. I think it's time to have a little chat with the old man.
Well done, stranger.
Skip it, Killian. What's your game?
I'm afraid I don't follow.
That was black magic raising those monsters. The same kind of magic you studied at Spook House.
Very clever, stranger. You would be a most worthy subject.
What's that supposed to mean?
Very worthy, indeed.
So this was Moloch's fate. Thank you.
Congratulations, stranger. You're doing fairly well so far. I hope my traps are to your liking. What do you think of me now, stranger? Am I crazy? No, I'm not crazy. I'm not the one who works alongside monsters. Did it anger you to find your fellow operative's emaciated corpse? Were you enraged, monster lover, to find nothing left but a corpse? I made this place to kill and torture monsters because they deserve no less.
Monster lover.
And you are here because you are no better. You are here to die, stranger. Know whom I admire, stranger? Harry Houdini, an unparalleled master of escape. Would that I could put him through my maze. If you hope to ever escape alive, I suggest you look him up. Welcome to my music room. This is one of my most beloved rooms. I am a man of culture. I find books and music exhilarating. There's a hint for you. Many times, books and music go hand in hand. I'm keeping tabs on our little game. I have sensors attached to every doorway in this mansion. I know when you enter and when you leave. You know you're much closer to me than you probably imagine. I'm directly below you in the ballroom. Come and get me now if you like, though I wouldn't recommend it. In the meantime, I'll be down here watching as you pick up that book.
Thank you.
You've entered my laboratory. This is where I have the most fun. Maybe one day you'll get to experience some of my best little toys.
Help me. That madman has held me captive here for weeks.
What are you doing? You can't see with the lights off.
That's the point. I don't have time for your distractions, succubus.
Stranger, you handled that succubus better than anyone before. I guess I'm going to have to find some other way to feed her this week. In case you don't make it through all my traps, I wanted to take this opportunity to say what a pleasure it has been putting you through my maze. I will report to Spookhouse that you died valiantly ridding my estate of monsters. Landon. I love having a test subject who can stand up to not only the physical rigors, but also the intellectual challenge of my maze. You've done well so far, but here's a trap that will require both body and mind to solve. Enjoy.
bricks are loose. There's another room behind this one.
Stranger,
Moloch.
I thought I would rot here for decades before seeing another Spookhouse agent.
There was a corpse in the cell upstairs. It looked like you.
It was my doppelganger. Killian intercepted me on my way to Strasbourg and threw me into this little rat maze of his. I concocted a double of myself to use as a decoy. I nearly escaped, but he caught me and dropped me into this icy pit.
Why hasn't he killed you?
That is beyond his power. How can he kill someone who has been expelled from both heaven and hell? He took full advantage of my immortality. He gets perverse joy from putting me through this rat maze. I'm his first test subject that can't be completely killed by his traps. I've been through this maze 17 times. Twice I almost escaped. Once I was within reach of the villain himself. And had I more strength, I would have eviscerated him on the spot. Stranger, you must free me. With my help, you can escape this place. And I can exact my revenge on that villain. Break the circle that contains me.
Accept my help, not as a personal favor, but as an obligation to Spookhouse.
Ah, thank you, stranger. Already I can feel my strength returning. But the cold here is unbearable. Killian knows that I take my strength from heat and fire. Find some means by which my dark soul can be warmed. This for a long time. And now there is just one final thing I need to fully regain my strength. While this fire fuels me, I need the energy found only in living blood.
Try it, and I'll finish what Killian started.
No, not you. I doubt your little body would begin to satisfy my thirst. There are creatures throughout this mansion. Have you seen any nearby?
Yes. You've saved us both, stranger. I am at full strength. Meet me in Killian's control room on the third floor. The day of reckoning has arrived for Hamilton Killian.
Stranger, you made it! Thank God! Help me! Get this fiend off me!
If there's anything you want to say to this man, stranger, say it now. He's on his way to a hell worse than the one that spawned me!
Stranger! Wait! Come back! Aren't you going to help me?
I'm sorry to hear about Hamilton. He was one of our best agents. After the death of his wife, he was never the same. He became very unstable. His retirement was only partially voluntary.
You spoke highly of him.
He was a good man at one time. And a good friend. I'm proud of you, stranger. You put aside your dislike for Moloch, and because of that, two of Spookhouse's best operatives are alive and well.
Make no mistake, Colonel. I freed Moloch solely for my benefit. Killian had no intention of releasing me, even if I survived his little game. Moloch wasn't part of Killian's master plan, so I made him part of mine. End of story.
Your motives are your own, stranger, but you've served this agency well. Good work. And more important than that, stranger, you've proven yourself capable of working with our agents, even those who are monstrous. I'll be honest with you, stranger. I've been concerned of late. I saw you becoming a young Hamilton Killian. He was a good friend, but the monster that he became, I hope that you will not follow the same path.
Blood on the desk. What the hell happened? Blood everywhere. No signs of life. No sign of Holiday. The computer's trashed. Holiday spare keys. One of these will open the briefing room door.